see our brothers and sisters, but a fire ought to start at home before you get to church. What God was doing, church, was resetting the way of their thinking process. When God frees us, we ought to be free indeed.
Amen.
Free indeed. Nothing. You, as I said, you ought to have a fire already in you. Somebody said, they broke out, they said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus, and all he has done for me.
Say that.
It said, my soul individually cries out, hallelujah.
Yeah.
I thank God for saving me. So we ought to be free in that manner. We just ought to be free because God has been good to us. Let's take a look at our scripture verses. As we position ourselves to come out of the box of it haven't happened before. You know how sometimes we box ourselves in when God want to do something. The devil tries to box us in emotionally. He tries to get in our minds that we say we haven't did that before, or you know, it hadn't happened before. We sometimes let that bother us, but God is getting ready to do a brand new thing in his churches. Have you noticed a shift change? It ain't us, it's God getting ready to do something brand new to help us, to aid us to go to heaven. Exodus 16, 4 and 5 verses say, then said, I want you to hear me, then said the Lord unto Moses, behold, when God said behold, that means listen, stand still, stop what you're doing. Behold, he said, not you, Moses, but I will rain bread from heaven for you. Anybody get that? For you. You called me. You brought the petition up. You put the request before me on behalf of your people. So God communicated back with Moses. Listen, I want you to hear me today. When I was meditating on this, the Lord showed me something. He said, I will rain bread from heaven. It hadn't happened before. They never did it. God never did it. But he said, Moses, I will rain bread from heaven for you. And the people, because he has blessed you. Mm-hmm. Let me share something. Well, God don't bless us just to be blessing us. He blessed us to be able to help somebody else. Yeah, that's what our foreparents did. If we go back into history, that's what our foreparents did. They had some green beans, salad, you name it, corn. They would take their neighbors some. Yeah, they want to bless everybody. Do you have any green beans? I just brought you a little bit of it. That's what they did. We didn't understand it. Let's talk a little bit more. When the preacher back then, anybody remember, would come to your house back then. Folks would feed the preacher back then.
Right.
Ooh, Lord have mercy. What happened to the back end? They did that. We let it bother us. You know we did. Look at the queen eating up all the chicken. Back then. Look at your neighbor and say, back then.
Back then.
Look what it says. And the people shall go out and gather a certain rate every day, that I may prove them You know God has been good to you. Some of us started out with one suit, one dress, one pair of shoes. But look what God has done. Somebody ought to get where you're at and realize you have a golden opportunity to show your gratitude towards your God. Listen what it says. It shall be twice as much as they gather daily. Think about that. Think about that. That's what we are still here. Our ancestors didn't have much, but they believed what thus said the Lord. Amen. And God blessed them. Church, God, he wants us to pass the test. Yeah, that's what we go through. You know, can't nobody help you in your test? Have you ever experienced a test and you try to tell somebody else about your test? And they're looking at you cross-eyed. You come for them for some help. But you got to understand, only God can bring you out of your test. Yeah, if you want to come out, you got to pay the test. Yeah, ain't no need to have no pity party while you're going through a test. You know how we whine, you know. Yeah, it looks like every day I wake up in the rain. Satan said, keep on saying that, keep on saying that, keep on saying it. You hear him, God, you hear him. They're talking about it's cloudy when the sun is shining. Have you ever wondered about a situation, even when we have a bad storm, somewhere the sun is shining. You ever thought about it? You ever looked down the road, it was raining down there, it was sunlight where you at? Ain't God awesome? He's showing up. That the sun is still, I'm going to shout in a minute. Y'all do what you want to do. I'm going to praise God. I don't need to get up here trying to feed and don't eat nothing. You know, a whole lot of folks cook. Ain't it, is it good? Did you enjoy it? You ought to taste it yourself. Now, this was the beginning point of touching and changing God's people, the beginning point.
All right.
It's hard for God to move his people forward as long as we are not sure who has the victory. Fear or faith. Somebody, as we categorize fear and faith, one of them is winning right now in somebody's life. Fear. Think about it. Fear. What would fear do to the church of the living God? Fear will stop you. Faith will push you.
Amen.
Check your soul out. Check your experiences out with God. When fear comes your way, fear comes to try to stop us.
Yes.
But faith push us.
Amen.
I'm sorry, feel what I feel right now. Think about it. Not only everybody's dealing with fear and faith. If you call yourself a child of God, you got fear knocking on your door, trying to stop you. Have you ever felt something even in your mind when you want to quit?
Yeah.
Have you ever felt something on your back pushing you to go ahead on?
All right now.
That's faith. Fear, it won't encourage us, but faith will.
All right.
Fear won't let us see God, but faith will. You ever been in some dark situation?
Yeah.
And only thing you needed was one peep to see your God.
Wow.
And you knew that everything would be all right. Fear, it shows us.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Only the darkness. But faith shows us the light. Fear, it hurts our future. But faith carries us forward. Child of God, by now in our Christian walk, ought to have faith to know that God will take care of us. How we measure things in life reveals how we feel about them and what we value.
Yes.
What did God send here? Verse 14, it says, and when the dew was laid
preacher.
Did Israel flunk the test? I'm glad you asked. And how? Verse 19, 20, and 21 says, and Moses said, let no man leave it till the morning.
All right.
Notwithstanding, they hearkened not unto Moses. But some of them left of it until the morning. And breed worms and stink. And Moses was wroth, talking about anger, with them. You know, it makes me mad when I see where faith ought to be. When it's not, it makes me hot.
All right.
It makes my temperature rise. And they gathered it every morning. Every man according to his eating. And when the sun waxed hot, it melted. Well, the question was, did they flunk the test? I come by to share that they flunked the test.
All right.
Because they did not listen to God's instruction.
All right.
That he gave the man of God. Maybe they were still in the box, thinking, I don't think it will work. We need more of our provision. What happens when we don't listen? It brings worms that rotten our faith. In the mental health, we use skill building tips. And I like to convert it over. We use tips about stop, look, and listen before you react. God's given us some skill building tips to use in our spiritual lives by the power of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is telling us today, stop, look, and listen before you react. Now, as I close here, what does God want us to do?
All right.
God, he wants us to depend on him and to trust him for our provision. Well, I guess I'll preach to myself here. God, he was teaching his people to trust in him.
Yes.
Lamentations 3 and 23 says, the Lord's loving kindness indeed never cease. For his compassion never fails.
Never.
They are new every morning.
Thank you, God.
Great is your faithfulness. Anybody knowing by now that every opportunity that God gives you to see another day, you ought to know that God is just being faithful to you. Come by to tell somebody that God is our provider. A songwriter wrote a song, and the title of that song is When We Walk with the Lord. I wish I had a preaching church here.
Come on.
It says, when we walk with the Lord in the light of his word.
Come on.
What a glory he said, on our way. While we do his good will, he abides with us still and with all who will trust and obey. Yeah, I just want to tell you the song says, trust and obey. need but to trust and obey.
Y'all ain't gonna work it.
Then he didn't stop right there. He said, not a burden we bear. I like this part. You know, because when you save, sometimes you go through burdens. He said, not a sorrow we share. But our toils, he doeth richly repay. Ain't that something you, when you go through stuff, God turn around and repay you for your toils. Not a grief or a loss. You know how it is. Sometimes you lose your loved ones. You think that it's over. Not a frown or a cross. But is blessed if we trust and obey.
All right now.